Attorney General Keith Ellison calls it one of the largest actions his office has taken to fight wage theft. A civil lawsuit tonight alleges that Evergreen Acres, a dairy farm with facilities in both Stearns and Redwood counties, has a history of substandard housing, stolen wages, and a culture of fear. Carol Evans' Carla Holt joins us now with more on this. Carla?
Well, Randy, Ellison alleges the largest dairy farm in central Minnesota, known collectively as Evergreen, robbed workers of both their wages and their dignity.
A Facebook page with the same name and location as the Evergreen Acres Dairy Farm paints a picture of a quiet, quaint Minnesotan farm. But that representation...
Really sad situation.
Advocates, officials, and a new lawsuit say does not accurately reflect the Evergreen Acres life.
They have rats, there is mold, there is water in the basement.
Ma Elena Gutierrez works with Fe y Justicia, a faith-based Latinx organization supporting the Latinx community in central Minnesota.
This has been happening for years.
Leading advocates say to a lawsuit filed today by Minnesota Attorney General Keith Ellison, the state alleges Evergreen failed to pay hundreds of workers, most of them undocumented workers from Mexico who speak limited or no English, at least $3 million in regular and overtime pay.
The size of the theft makes this one of the largest enforcement actions our office has taken to fight wage theft.
The lawsuit also describes how the Paintsville employer served as landlord with few housing options available in the area, providing, quote, squalid, substandard living conditions for workers with mold, mildew, insects, and without, in some cases, windows, heat, a toilet.
These residences violated most basic health and safety standards, and they are frankly not within the bounds of human decency.
And while the lawsuit seeks millions of dollars for the Evergreen workers, advocates say it also seeks to remind workers they do have rights.
You have a right. You are a human.
Ma Elena encourages workers to reach out if they have questions or concerns about their rights. We'll provide that information on our website, care11.com. Meantime, Ellison also noted that under deferred action relief, undocumented workers do not face any legal actions by the U.S. Department of Homeland Security. I did leave many messages for Evergreen and its owners today and have not heard back. Randy?
All right, Carla, thank you.